Alright, doing an old game this time. Really old. Gremlins on the Atari 2600. It's kind of like Kaboom, and if I should compare it to it, it's kind of like that kind of infamous game called Beat 'em and Eat 'em, but it's better than that. Let's put it that way. All you do is run back and forth across, I think you're Billy's father or something like that, and you try to catch Gizmo before he falls on sandwiches. That's what it looks like to me. And at the bottom, you can see on the left, there's Gizmo. And after he turns into a full-on gremlin, apparently. Which the only difference is he just gains some height. I don't know. And as you see here, there's many different levels. Also, levels for two players. And then there's also demo. But who cares about that? So, let's get going. You have three lives, and do as good as you can. This is a lot more detailed than those other two ones I mentioned. Especially the last one. That piece of shit. Ugh. But do I like this morning Kaboom? Play-wise, no. Concept-wise, yes. I like the two Gremlins movies. What can I say? That's getting faster. And there we go. I didn't miss any. Guaranteed that's not going to happen next. And this is what I didn't mention yet because I wanted you to see it. You move into this mode where it's now like a shooter. So you actually get variety in this game. It's kind of like Space Invaders a little bit. There you go. And now they're really fast. So the idea is basically if they get to the hamburgers, wherever the hell they are, they'll turn into gremlins. So the more of those, obviously, you don't want. And they turn into eggs. Shit, I wasn't fast enough. Hitting the button here doesn't do anything, by the way. Ooh. I can't believe I'm actually doing as good as I am. Oh man, that's not good. I'm gonna have a lot of these bastards I gotta shoot. I don't know if it's just me because the low fidelity, but the graphics for the eggs at the top kind of look like alien eggs from the Alien series. Now I know the next round's gonna go horribly wrong. Oh, I was doing good for a second there. It's not that bad, really. I kinda like this. I could see using this as like a time waster. That's a lot of these Atari games really were. Or just trying to get as high score as you can. This one I more make like bets with people, see like how long you can go for until you fail. Alright, I'm still going. I like doing these Atari 2600 games. It's not because they're short, it's not because they're simple, it's just, I don't know, you don't get to see enough of them. Ooh, level 8. Damn, I can't get any of them. Well, I got 1, 2, 3. Shh. But this is why I have lives. I haven't lost any yet. I will say, though, I kind of wish that in the second game mode, they were a little faster. Oh, they are getting a little faster now. They're giving multiple ones at a time. Oh, and there you go. I finally lost a life, and now I'm back here. See, the problem is I'm doing what I do in racing games. I'm trying to anticipate where they're going to go. Just like you input it in that turns. Shit. Now, the first time I played this, I actually thought that you would die or lose a life or something like that, or points, if you don't catch any of them. But no, you just get more, you have to shoot here. So technically, if you're bad at that, I guess you could just intentionally let them all fall, but that's stupid. You know, you gotta at least try. There you go. I was a little more accurate that time. All these Atari games work the same way. As it gets harder, or you can do it with difficulty A and B sliders, is it usually gets faster. That's really all that happens. But then it's actually very impressive to think how fast these games can get, you know, considering that way back when. And there's some people that can really do it good. There's some of these I can do fast, but not others. Oh, I got one. Oh, I got two. Three. I don't know what that lull was just right there. So I got seven. I got seven of them. I think that's pretty good, considering. Now these guys are really moving fast. I got as many as I can. I think I'm on my last one. Yeah, last life. It's the final countdown. I don't know who this is, but man, he must be physically fit if he can run back and forth like this. Alright, last chance. Wow, that couldn't get any closer. I gotta put my defender skills to work. Wow, I got that one. I wasn't even... Oh. He was right at... Wait, how am I getting to continue? I guess I actually earned a life. And I died at the same time, so it kind of... I got a life, but I also lost it at the same time. I think that's what happened. Usually that only happens in Tempest, and then I'm very confused. I really like these Atari games, though. Why, for a good amount of time, I was trying to get a 7800 because I was told it gets better picture quality. RF doesn't bother me, but you do get better picture out of that. But anyway, that's Gremlins on the Atari 2600. I like it. You know, it's worth playing. It's kind of like Kaboom or the other one I mentioned. There's a couple other ones that play the same way. But this one's interesting. I don't know what else to say. I recommend, you know, playing it, trying it, getting it, whatever. It's a pretty decent Atari 2600 game, and in a sea of tons of games for the thing, there's a lot of bad ones in the mix, as you might know, so having a halfway decent one like this, that's legitimately challenging. Yeah, I recommend it. Although I think this would be a lot more hilarious and fun in two-player mode. I'm just saying. Just to see who can outdo each other. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you later.